I like days like this. I've got up bright and breezy. I've travelled down to Portsmouth because I'm here today to see Dan from DJE Electrical Services. Dan left some comments on a video that I produced on the 10-way fully loaded BG consumer unit. Dan's a massive fan of that product and I'm going to get a chance today to spend some time with him out on site. So let's go find him. So Dan, how's it going? Thanks for inviting me down.
Yeah, all good, all good.
What are we up to?
We are changing a domestic fuse board today. We have a split load board in at the minute, an old plastic style. We're going to be adding a new fuse board, metal clad, obviously 18th edition with SPD.
And dare I ask, what is the make of that board?
Have a little guess.
Is it by any chance a BG board?
In one.
So let's see him install a BG board today.
There we go.
Well, he never mentioned he was this rapid. He's already in, isolated the board, and the old one's going out. So if the customer changes their mind now, Dan, we're in trouble, aren't we?
We may well be.
Always my favourite bit of this is get the board on the floor and then turn to the customer and say, do you remember where any of those connections went?
Yes.
always find it livens up the payment process when your Wi-Fi's not coming back on.
I hope someone's got a clue, because I haven't.
Yeah, it's a classic one line of that.
Right, just getting the other circuits out, ready. They're all labelled and nicked.
Okay, ready so you know where they're going?
Yeah, I just use a nick system.
Okay, yeah, I did as well. So.
Simple. I find tape pulls off.
Yeah. Writing's another job, isn't it, when
yeah,
nicks are fine.
And I can't do it, so. That involves spelling.
Yeah. So just to update people who are watching the video, full electrical installation condition report was done. You showed me that report off camera, and we were actually at the stage. We were interested in the actual consumer unit change itself.
Yep.
Introducing surge, which is great.
Okie doke.
Yeah, so this one's going to be off in seconds, so.
I can find why that's not coming out. It's dim now, it, Connor.
I used to find it fascinating when you got like three poses and one slotted, things like that.
All right, well that's off.
So, moment of truth, the old one's out. Is the new one going to fit in that gap there, Dan?
Well, we hope so, mate, because it's a little bit too late now if it doesn't. So let's get that in there. Like a glove.
Look at that, made to fit.
Like a glove, mate. A
couple of things I really like about it. The spirit level on the left-hand side up there, really good. Yeah, you find that useful?
Agreed, yeah. I just think it's a little touch for me, just to get it obviously nice and straight. Another really interesting, good point about these is the screws have obviously come ready for you just to screw in. You haven't got to unscrew them in. Obviously at the risk, when you get to the end here as well, they bite.
Right.
So you can't unscrew it and it just falls out, which is a little beauty, I think.
And the gap on the right hand side, ideal for the tails, isn't it?
It's huge, yeah. If you can't sweep a tail in there, I think you're doing something wrong. And you know, you can drill your hole, loads of room up here, sweep them in, nice joins. So yeah, all in all, a solid board, I think.
I think you've had a bit of luck there with the size of that cupboard and the size of that board. So well done, Dan.
No luck involved.
Okay, so you're going to do rear entry on this board, Dan.
And I am indeed.
Comes with all the stuff in the kit, doesn't it?
It does. Comes with a little plastic bit for the middle, which clips in. It shouldn't go anywhere once it's clipped, but I always like to add a bit of super glue just to make sure, because obviously cable entry is very important. So yeah, I don't think enough people take it seriously. We do need to grommet stuff. We've got sharp metal edges. So also we've got this grommet strip here, which I can place around these two entry holes. And again, with a bit of super glue, just sturdies everything up, peace of mind for me, so when I've mounted the board I know the cables are safe.
And the grommet strip as well as the other strip were all included in the kit?
All comes with the kit, yeah.
They've all included, everything, haven't they?
They have indeed, and blanks.
I've just seen you do the first part of the dim round, nice little feature there. Show us again, Dan, what you're up to.
It was just literally, they put little nicks in it, so it's just a case of a bit of gentle persuasion, you haven't got to go mad with the saw, and away you go.
Okay, now it's ready to be fitted.
It is indeed.
Tick them off as I go in. Another one in. Yeah. Once they're all in, that's it. I'm stripping.
Nice feeling.
Doing a bit I like doing. Dressing. Yeah.
Making it a piece of art.
Plenty of room though, yeah?
Yes.
Agreed?
Yeah, that's very, all. Very nice bit of room, mate. It's just, yeah, I find them just nice to work with.
The depth of the back. When I was putting my hand in, I haven't got a man's size hand like you, Dan, but when I was putting my hands back there, I was thinking, God, there's an incredible amount of room to dress cables behind the breakers and the din rail.
But yeah, that's exactly it, and that's what we're looking for, is just little things that are going to make our lives easier. Little things that are just going to make the install easier, go smoother. That's what we're looking for in every... Nick this new cable, that's a two, Nick.
Yeah, don't want to lose your markings. So most of the cables are in. We're going to make a few connections to extend a few cables. So we're in a good place.
All right, yeah, they're in.
Any top tips for your layout? You got a layout in mind?
Always try and spread it. So I've got a ring main on one, ring main on the other, lighting. So obviously just diversity, just giving it a bit of leeway. If you lose one half, you're not going to lose all your lights. If you lose one half of the board, you're not going to lose all your sockets.
Absolutely.
Try and keep it that way, because obviously we bang on about when we do RCBOs about nuisance stripping, so it's also good to get the most out of a split load board. Yeah. And use it for what it's there for, really.
And again, you've offered the customer, you know, to have a full RCBO board. It's down to the customer's choice,
without a doubt. And obviously, I understand, you know, you're looking at probably a minimum of £200 more.
But the option was there.
Yes. So they've always got that option, and I think that's important.
So we're at the exciting stage. We've extended all the circuits that didn't quite reach the board position, and you're off and running.
Yeah, we'll get ready to strip now, identifying the rings and stuff, and obviously, you know, getting it all dressed in so I can get earth swept in, neutral swept in. Otherwise, it becomes a bit of a bird's nest, which could be an absolute pain in the backside to work on.
But this is the fun part of it, you know, any installation. You do a rewire, you're hunkered down here, and I think your son's off running around finishing all the second fix. You've probably got Instagram on the go at the same time. Dad will do the board. Obviously we're going after this. We're going to show it, but obviously we're going to complete the full installation testing. You've done your pre-inspection test, which we've seen off camera. Mm-hmm. This is just the fun bit, really, isn't it? We're trying to show you. We're not showing you patching up any hole replacements or anything like that. We're just purely just having a look at the ease and comfort, I think, that the BG board brings to the electrical contractor. So if you were to take a stab at it, how many BG boards do you think you've fitted in your time?
Crikey, it's thousands. Thousands. We used to run all of council contracts. I've been installing them since I can remember, to be quite honest. And this is why I've never had really a bad thing to say against them. And it's just nice in with the screw, it's all set, you just bend it in. I just find it's a lot of room to work in there.
And all the screw heads, am I right in thinking, are all the same, what are they called, plus, minus, or slightly posi, whichever you want to say? Yeah, so you could use one screwdriver for the whole thing?
Whole board, everything.
Okay, we will be going back for the torque screwdriver before the first person jumps in. Obviously, we're just nipping them in at the moment.
Yes.
So with the way you dress the cables, I'd see you taking the line conductors down the back where the pin rail is. Obviously, you do line and then you go neutral or earth next. Is that really the thinking behind it? Okay.
That's it, mate.
So rather than sweeping your neutrals across in your CPCs, you give yourself the maximum amount of room, even though there's a huge amount of room behind there.
Yeah, it's
just fold them out of the way.
That's just how I've always done it, I suppose. I'm quite cack-handed with things at times, but it's just how I find the process to do it. It works easier for me. Otherwise, I find I'll just end up with a bird's nest. And the OCD in me just wants to scream. If you know where you're at with it, you can work on it. If there's any faults or anything like that.
And we're showing parts of this video. We're not going to show it all. We're not trying to do a DIY guide here of how to do a consumer unit. We're just showing, you know, some of the great practice that I've seen throughout today with you, Dan.
Cool.
The line conductors coming together now, and we nearly finished those. We've obviously split them according to what we discussed earlier, upstairs and downstairs, really split across each
shower,
one.
Cooker, just the two bigger ones.
It come fully populated with the breakers. You did have to swap one of them out. You swapped out a 32, but they pretty much cover most situations, you think?
Yeah, definitely. They put the 140 in, obviously for 10mm showers. I always put my showers on a 10mm. 40. And then obviously the 32s, they come with 432s, 216s, and is it 4.6s or 3.6s? So yeah, it's a nice spread of what you need.
And the SPD was fully wired in when you got it as well, which 100%. I thought was nice. Yeah, didn't send you the kit, actually they've done that for you and all.
It's all done, yeah. So saving me, I've got to just check the tightness and go from there. Right,
you got any top tips from not missing it or not? It doesn't matter if you haven't.
No, I always unscrew as much as you can until you can't feel it going anymore. And once you've unscrewed it, you'll know, you'll feel it. It just keeps going round. Then yep. What I do before I do it is I'll just push.
Just to send them back.
Send them all back. But always have a look, because even there, look, the third one still hasn't gone right back. So it would be quite easy to miss it.
Yeah.
But then just hold it in like that. I always screw this end.
Yep.
So that we don't get a bend on the dim rail. Hence why some people may struggle with the lids. And then I just do this end, and it just then, we've done the two ends. It means once we tighten in between, it should sit a lot straighter.
Yeah. And like we said earlier, you're gonna go back in, obviously talk them all up at the end. We're yeah. Snipping them through in a minute. But your line conductor are all done nice and neat. I like the neutrals as well, just CPCs to go.
Yep.
And that'll be probably us somewhere in the region of finishing this board.
Yes.
So we're coming towards the end of it, where the CPCs are going in now, before obviously we go off testing. What would be your feedback for BG on their boards? Because not everything's perfect.
Well, no, exactly that. And I mean, no board's perfect. There's a few little downsides to this. One being the knockout for the tails isn't in line. So I've drilled my own here, but it could do with having a knockout there. So it's, you know, little things like that. Also, the up to dim rail. This is solid because I believe if you dress the cables in properly and you screw it to a decent, I mean, that's not going anywhere. But I have had in the past where they leaned forward with the weight on them. So I think maybe just one more solid attachment in the middle of the dim rail will stop that from happening. And you do get issues with the lid. But again, I think that's down to the rail. And if that can be sorted, I think that would take that element away. So yeah, it's not perfect. But as I say, it's definitely one of my favourites to work on.
So we'd like to thank you, Dan, for your time today.
Worries.
Brilliant,
thank
mate.
Thank you for coming, yeah. Mate.
So I'd looked at the BG Consumer Unit as a live feed event, and today we got to see it out in action. So what's our summary thoughts on it, Dan?
Again, enjoyed the install. Decent boards, solid boards, fun to work on with the SPD. Loads of space. So yeah, I think we've done a good job. It looks good, safe, tested, customers happy, 18th edition, and all for a very, very good price, reasonable price. So I can't really grumble with the BG.
As always, we're interested in your thoughts and your comments. Please make sure you leave them below, and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.
Happy days. Just one thing left, I guess, if you don't mind, mate.
Thanks.